Plaintiff Christine Wasko just wanted to keep her son cool while he recovered from spinal surgery, but wound up getting conned out of $850. Defendant Victor Reed says he did exactly what the plaintiff paid him to do and doesn't owe her anything.
Please raise your right hands. Do you swear the testimony you're about to give is the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth?
Yes.
Yes.
Hey, Najee.
Got case number 75 on the docket, Wasko versus Reed.
We have here the plaintiff, Ms. Wasko, and you are suing Mr. Reed for $850 for the reimbursement of an air conditioning unit. And you are, sir?
I'm your son, Coy Myers.
Okay, nice to have you both here. Now, what's going on?
Judge, I'm here to get my money back that was stolen from this con man. He literally came.
Con man? For real?
Came. He talked to me on the phone. If you've ever been in Texas in August, it's like 115 degrees.
Yes.
And a girlfriend of mine had located Mr. Reed.
Here come the con.
I called Mr. Reed. He sounded knowledgeable, just like my girlfriend had said. And he was willing to come out on the weekend. I get over there. He brought this unit. He took the old one. He put this other unit there.
So he put a new air conditioning unit in.
A refurbished unit.
A refurbished unit.
With 3-year warranty on it. And then when he went to flip on the breakers, he says, oh, your whole panel box needs replaced. My unit's good. You need to get somebody to replace your panel box. And I said, you guarantee the unit's good? Yes, ma'am, I do. It's never worked. We did exactly what he said. We put additional money out. Had other panels put in.
So it never produced air conditioning?
Never. Nice. It never even worked. He said, I'll come right back.
He gave us a 3-year warranty. It's never worked for 3 seconds.
Right now, what we're trying to decide, mm-hmm. and I'm going to hear from you now, but is whether the air conditioning unit that he put in with the 3-year warranty, you're saying it never worked once?
Never turned on.
Okay.
Never worked.
What do you say about that, sir?
Sir, this is a blatant example of systematic racism that a black contractor has to go through, especially in the South. This woman called me on a Sunday, a mercy call.
It wasn't
Sunday. I was advertising a used unit.
Yes.
She called me. So I get there. The unit was good. All right? I installed it, but this is...
You did install it.
Yes, sir. I installed it. The panel was bad, the electrical panel. This is the first example. I told him I also do electrical panels. For some reason... He has this friend
He has
this friend that can fix anything. Okay? So I say, well, get it fixed. He know it was working, it was cooling him.
It never
now,
worked.
My unit's working.
Yeah,
he's seen it working. Yeah.
I did not see it working. It never worked.
He was outside of the house the whole time, man. Hey. You one of those customers that stay on people back the whole time, dude.
I couldn't walk.
Yeah.
I just had surgery.
These people,
I was fighting
man,
for
and
my
I knew
life.
They were gonna, I knew they were gonna do that.
When he put the unit in, you just said it's working.
Yeah.
And it was cooling him.
Yeah.
And you're saying it wasn't
that
working?
That was a lie.
No,
that
sir.
Was a
that,
here comes
lie.
The lie.
You're saying it worked when you first turned it on. You're saying it didn't. What evidence are you going to show me now about that?
So he came in and he installed the AC, and at the end he says it's not working because you need to replace your electric panel.
So your electrician came over to fix it.
Done exactly what he said. I've already given you the evidence.
Tampered with my unit.
No, never touched the unit, just the electrical box. You have the evidence there of exactly what he told me to purchase. I purchased that. He done it. Nobody ever touched the unit.
You say this electrical guy touched the unit.
I installed the unit, and the unit kept breaking the breaker. So when I came and diagnosed it, because I do electrical work too.
Yes.
And I diagnosed it. I said, man, you need a box.
After he installed the electrical unit, he came in and said, it's not working because you need to change your electrical panel. You need a new electrical panel. He said, and when you get the electrical panel replaced, you can turn on the panel and the AC will work. He said, it will work, I promise you. He goes, I only live 15 minutes away. I'll come back and set everything up.
And I came back.
I'm still talking.
And when I came back, what did I tell you I observed? The
sir,
dude has been...
let them finish.
Then after we did get an electrician to come put the panel in. Once he put the electrical panel in, we flipped it on, we tried I turned the AC, it sounded like an old junk car. The AC would not run at all. It's never ran. Me and my wife, we're all sweating bullets. I'm really fighting for my life. After I had spine surgery, I had a leak on my spine and the water is going to my brain. I literally could not stand up.
His sickness don't have nothing to do with air conditioning. Well, no. I mean, we can really, a real businessman to tell you that.
Either the unit, while you were there, did turn on, or while you were there, it didn't turn out. They're saying it didn't. You're saying it did. One of you is not telling
Judge
the truth.
Judge Jerry, what I feel, and I've been doing this for 23 years.
I don't doubt your experience.
But what I'm saying is, it's a third party that got involved. He said he was going to get it done on a Monday. This man called me three weeks later.
You have said that while you were there in the beginning, it did turn on.
Yeah, he heard it. Didn't he? Okay. He just said it.
After we replaced the panel, when they turned the AC, like, nothing came on. Like, it sounded like a junk car. Like, it was not running. It was not producing any cool air.
The motor was on, but it wasn't producing any cold air. Running. That's what an air conditioner should do.
That's where the manipulation, comes in. I got impeccable record.
Yeah.
And I'm not going to let these people destroy it. Not gonna happen.
No. I have a lot of things. First of all, on that impeccable record, I like to show some evidence. His previous customers.
Mm-hmm. This is, and the racist.
You are racist. This, but it has a lot to do with it, sir.
He probably has more white friends than
all right. Here are some reviews from your...
Go right ahead, sir.
One says, shows no respect to others. How his business has lasted long is beyond me. And he is racist. Another person...
Saying that I'm racist. Is that what she said? Or yes. Him or whoever?
Yeah. Racist trash would never make a dime off me. That's someone else.
Mm-hmm.
He is racist and he steals money, as previous comments say. This person, this guy, Victor, stole my money. He scammed me. You have to report it.
Seven complaints over 23 years.
No, that was just a page that was.
See, that's what I'm saying. Seven complaints over 23 years.
All right.
Sir,
all right.
That's
all right. That just has to do.
Yeah, it's part of business.
In this case, obviously, the air conditioning is not working. It's not working. Why would they bother coming here if the air conditioning's working? How much you were responsible for it not working is another question. But it's not working, and they paid $850 to you to get it fixed, and then you paid other money for the other stuff, which you probably need anyway.
Yeah.
So I'm not going to make him pay the other stuff that you're going to need anyway. But the $850, you are entitled to get back because you didn't get what you paid for. I fine for the plaintiff $850.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Trash, man.
Man, I understand.
You can't scare off the black contractor. I'ma be here. Trust me. That's why I'm here.
And you're here because you ripped this
off. No, I'ma stop letting y'all people do that to my people. I'm letting y'all people stop doing that to my people, man.
Everything that was said in there was just such a lie. I'm just glad that justice was here.
Because at the end of the day, this man lied about everything. You know, he couldn't walk. He couldn't do nothing, but he got somebody to come out there and do the panel and all that. No, man, this fool's just gonna stop, man. We'll be right back.